you can't just get a big ass snake tattoo and then go back to some fucking bean recipe. Frank, what the fuck, man?
You guys are a bunch of fucking comedians now, huh? You know, I find it unlikely any of you would say that to my 5'9" behemoth of a man frame with a menacing snake tattoo. Jokes aside, I didn't really show you guys the scars and explain a little more, which I should have done in the beginning of that vlog. And I think I did say that I didn't really want to get a tattoo. I'm not a big fan of tattoos, but after thinking about it for a while, that was what I decided I'm doing. Warning, I'm about to show you guys my tits. So if you're not into that, if you're at work or something, you might want to click off this or just listen. But there were two main issues. The scars, which weren't super bad, but the bigger problem was the asymmetry. You know, the right side was significantly bigger than the left. So I would have had to get another surgery to even it out, if that was even possible. You know, the surgeon I went to for the gynecomastia surgery didn't want to do it. He said the scarring would be even worse and it wouldn't look good. And then after that surgery, I would have had to get some other type of procedure to reduce the scars. And I mean, is that even possible? You know, the scarring is already bad enough. And with the tattoo, just the dark black ink over it, it's barely passable right now. It's barely passable right now, at least in my opinion. So I think if I did get a few more procedures to try to fix the asymmetry and fix the scars, it might have just gotten worse overall and I might have had to get the tattoo anyway. So look, I don't really know. I don't know if there was a reasonable solution, but some of the comments that you guys left were were worth making a video for on their own. Every step of the way. You, as someone who is so concerned about non-toxic, non-inflammatory diet and environmental influences, and get a tattoo, I can't stop thinking, why? Guys, I thought this out. You know, I figured that me being able to do fitness content and do shirtless stuff, and that it was better to get the tattoo and do that than to just give up on fitness content, because that's honestly what I was going to do, you know. I can't be making videos and then people just comment that, oh, you had gynecomastia, did you do steroids? I don't have a fucking hair on my body. I can't grow a beard. Like, you guys think I did steroids? It's fucking ridiculous. It's fucking comedians. Alex C. How many snake tattoos has Frankie shit on and now he has one himself? World is ending confirmed. I agree. Brodo Man. Frank must have met a member of the club at a sauna who wanted him branded to lift his shadow bands. Maybe they would have stopped placing fake orders and stealing money from me if that was the case. Ramon Gonzalez. It actually looks really good. Like a 70s mustache with a very tight cop uniform and a bar called the Manhole. Oh my god, you guys with the gay jokes. It never ends. It's not like the snakes are making out with each other, you know? It's not like they're pink. You guys are fucking... Harja. A year from now, Frankie will be huffing and puffing Lucky Strikes or something. Yeah, I'll be in Alaska with the Eskimos smoking natural tobacco, for sure. Our brother, where art Liam? You should tell Hitomi about the new tattoo. You guys can bond about your snakes. Honestly? If I didn't make like three videos talking crap about Hitomi's snake tattoo, the response to this wouldn't have been as bad. So I don't know. I couldn't think of anything to do besides the snakes. Randall Oland, this has to be fake. If only. This Frankie boy is following Hitomi's ways. Yeah, those Hitomi videos are gonna burn me. Ash Tarsharan. No offense, bro, but I think you're going to regret it just as many other people. You even mentioned it in a video why getting a tattoo is not really a great idea. Yeah, I mean, I'll say it again. Like, I don't like tattoos. I would never have wanted to get one, but in the spectrum of things that I thought would fix the chest appearance for fitness content, this is what I ended up doing. Ari, I feel like Frank realized there's little value in trying to live a 100% healthy lifestyle if you're miserable doing it. That works for like going out and doing things you enjoy. In my case, like, I don't really care like about tattoos, but VT, either Frankie joined the club or this mastermind is pulling some stunt on Hitomi. I just refuse to believe you would get two serpents even for the scars. I had an original tattoo idea that I really wanted to do. It was like a pretty cool looking seahorse, and then it had like some type of space background and stuff. But I realized that the amount of ink for that, seahorse is kind of feminine. It didn't really match. Basically, the tattoo artist explained to me it might not look that great as a tattoo in general. So the snakes were not my idea, but it's what we decided on doing. Mercutio Cordis. Blink if you need help. They finally got him. Operation Midnight, Frankie. Yeah, not yet. Well, if you guys saw what I was doing the other night, maybe you would think that. I had two Colombian girls, and they loved my snake tattoo. I swear on this shitty tattoo, two Colombian girls, one on each side, holding my chest. Swear to God. They liked the fucking tattoo. They liked it. It was like a two-for-one deal. This really beautiful, tall, slim girl was with her friend. I mean, she was like a 9 point, dude, 9 point. She literally looked like a fox, 9.5. And her friend, save that story for another day. Sammy, I'm looking forward to the eventual tattoo removal and detox video. Jason Cruz Jr. Didn't Frankie make a video on how tattoos are bad for your liver? Yeah. I mean, it's more of an immune system thing because I didn't notice any real issues after getting the tattoo. Most of the ink does stay in the skin, so definitely an immune thing. Tom Evans. Do I remember watching a video with Frank explaining the toxicity of tattoo inks? Yes, we did two videos on it. Justin and Randy Training. Don't worry about all the hate, bro. Live your life. I'm a top-tier holistic health practitioner, and I'm getting a throat tattoo in a week. It's always going to be the people below you that talk shit. I mean, I don't know if this was a condescending, sarcastic comment, but I'm kind of picking out the funny ones and like the trash talking comments. About half of the comments people liked it. Samuel Bai. It will be interesting to see if you do heavy metal testing later as a follow-up. Keep us updated. Yeah, that's why this is a business expense, because we're going to do hair mineral analysis maybe 2-3 months from now and see if the heavy metals have gone up. So self-experimenting, business expense, government should be writing me a check. Zero tension. I've said it before, Frankie's going to be drinking tap water one of these days. Jokes aside, cool tap. I'd rather die of dehydration than drink tap water. Although I do have sorbet at restaurants, so that they use tap water to make. So we got to get our own restaurant in the city, guys. It's going to be all Mountain Valley water. I'm still waiting for the check from them. Jazz, don't trust a guy with a snake tattoo. Okay, I might have said that before about girls with snake tattoos. All right, I deserve the shit. Jake Peters, is there a certain type of non-toxic ink you used? So I actually went back and forth with the tattoo studio for months before getting the tattoo, because I was like, look, can I bring my own natural ink? Do you guys use natural ink? And I decided that, okay, even though they're using a regular synthetic tattoo ink, if I'm going to get a tattoo, I want it to look good and be the best possible, not like, and they wouldn't have used the natural ink anyway. Like that tattoo shop I was going to, it was out of the question. They weren't going to do it. So maybe I could have found another tattoo artist that would have used a natural ink, but then the tattoo would not have been as good. So I thought about it, guys. I thought about it. No food. Yakuza boy is back. I was actually talking to the manager at that tattoo shop. They have a guy that comes in and that used to do tattoos, or still does tattoos for the Yakuza guys in Japan. And he visits New York once in a while. But there's a big difference between those Yakuza guys getting multiple layers of ink all over their entire body versus a tattoo like this. Big difference. Ruby. Since you're Italian, a pepperoni pizza for the nipples would have been perfect. Yeah. Dr. Shafty. Gotta say, I didn't see that coming. Sick looking tattoo, Frankie. Hey, listen. I've been looking up snake tattoos on Google for the past 3 days. I haven't seen one, at least, that I think looks as good as this, so maybe I'm just delusional. J.A. Frankie, aren't tattoos toxic, though? Also, couldn't you have grown some chest hair with minoxidil? Or was that not aesthetic for you? Yeah, bro. I was going to grow enough fur on my chest to completely cover up my nose. Do you guys think when you say shit, like, first of all, I don't even know if you could grow enough hair to cover up your nipples. And if you did, it would look absolutely disgusting. Like, you guys are ridiculous. Yeah, bro. Rub minoxidil on my nipples. I'm sure you want me to film it, too, you fucking comedian. I Muggles. Holy shit, it actually ended up looking badass. It fits you perfect. See, boys, the plan is working. The goth baddies are already in my comments section. Raven's Roll Top. It looks good, but I think you should leave it as is. I've heard tattoos can be addicting, so don't go crazy. Yeah, I don't exactly want to get another one. Abdullah Alajmi. Guys, chill. The tattoo is the new FDA's logo. Just joking, Frank. I love too much. Yeah, probably right on that. Bridget. I vote for something in the middle. Whatever the tattoo artist recommends. Yeah, I do think it'll look better with something in the middle. I do want to get like a skull or something, but one, this place is super expensive. Two, I don't want the extra ink. Three, I don't want to sit in a tattoo chair that long. Four, it would cover up my abs and stuff, so I don't really want to cover up anything that I don't have a problem with. So look, if another tattoo could instantly appear in the middle of my chest, I'd probably do it, but right now, definitely not. Just to balance it out. Laz from LA, could have got a much smaller tattoo for covering surgery scars. I asked the tattoo artist about this. He basically explained, okay, well, then you're going to have nipple tattoos. It's going to look weird. It's going to look like a nipple tattoo. So the solution was we got to do something that doesn't look like a nipple tattoo. And as a bonus, this covers up, like my stretch marks are still really bad up here, but this actually covers up a lot of stretch marks up here. So it covers up the scars on the nipples, and then it goes up, it covers the stretch marks up here. And then I think from a cover-up perspective, you can't get much smarter than this. Eli Yuck, I think it looks good. The tats are a little side heavy. You should definitely get something on your sternum to even it out. Yeah, no, the issue is if I don't want to get something that goes like down to my abs and stuff, although Sloppy Joe. Guys, I have stretch marks on my ass. Should I get snakes tattooed on my ass to cover them up? Maybe you should, bro. Lunar 7777. Lead directly into your bloodstream. Great for your liver. Legitimately, your logic makes no sense at this point, but at least your ribeyes are the best I've ever had. LOL. Yeah, guys. Go to frankiesyrangemeat.com. Support me before I completely lose my mind and get snakes tattooed on my neck. Blinky Bill. Surely you could have gotten an Italian-based tattoo. I mean, technically I'm Italian, but like I'm not really Italian. I guess I'm American, so I don't know what I would have gotten that's Italian. One thing that I didn't say that's really important, and if you look up chest tattoos, you'll notice this. The only ones that look good are symmetrical. So if you're going to do something on the chest, it has to be completely identical on each side. Then it looks like a piece, you know? Whenever you see chest tattoos and there's like one thing here, one thing here, one thing here, it looks like someone just drew on your body. So if you want something that actually looks like artwork and looks good and like people look at it and say, oh, that looks great, all the chest tattoos that are completely symmetrical on the left and right side are good. YouTube channel needs a nice big pentagram in the middle just so nobody is confused about who you said. If I do that, will you secret society cocksucker stop placing fake orders on my business and stealing money from me? Herald of the Metal Gods. Lamo Gay Max. What's with you guys and the gay jokes? TwinkMAXXING. At least be funny with it. But those were the comments. Maybe there were like a few more that I missed that I could have put up here. But yeah, I kind of set myself up for this one. Between the videos, recent videos talking about how bad tattoos are for you. And all the jokes about Hitomi's snake tattoo and the jokes that many jokes I made about snake tattoos. It's a little bit hypocritical, but hopefully the reasoning is with the cover up and that type of stuff. Otherwise, I don't know if I'm still going to do that much fitness content, but at least like I'll do some shirtless stuff, mainly for TikTok too. I don't know if I'm going to post a lot of that stuff on YouTube, but we'll see. I got to stop eating so much and maybe we'll do that. But thank you guys for joining me. Who knows what's next, right? Who knows what's next? Yeah, I think that's it. We got some cool stuff going on this week. So definitely keep an eye on the YouTube channel, guys, as well as your emails if you're signed up, whether it's frank-chapon.com or frankiesyrangemeat on the email list. But as always, if you guys could please drop a like on the video, leave a comment down below. Make sure to subscribe and check that notification bell. And I'll see you guys soon.